So this is the Kinetic finger prototypes. Prototype 1 and prototype 2. You need to turn on your imagination a little bit when watching this video, because you have to imagine 11 fingers next to each other here, like a piano keyboard for the vibraphone. All 11 falling down into place and starting to play the melody, because every time a marble is dropped, one of these fingers is lifted by the programming pins, like this. So imagine here, 11 fingers, all go back, and 11 fingers, stoop. First, I made this one, and as you can see, this has another angle than this one. Then I realized that if I have some counterweights, I can get this little tip of the finger to turn inwards towards the musical instruments. Then I realized that if I freed up this movement, it could bend around. I could actually make the finger cross the balance point with this counterweight. And instead of remaining like that in muted position, it could fall back like this. And when you go and watch the Marble Machine X live, and it's 25,000 people in the audience, maybe a little bit more, then you will be able to see the Marble Machine X playing from a big distance, even if we're playing on a big stage. No sound will be heard now. Okay, so when I show prototypes, there's always the risk of you taking this a little bit too literally. Like, what you see is not what you get always. That's why it's called prototype. But just to be very clear, these fingers is not releasing the marbles. It's this thing down there that is releasing the marbles. But that movement is very tiny, so the visual fingers help accentuate that movement. Okay, so time for me to CAD prototype 3. But before I do that, I want to show you how I built this first prototype. All these 19 Kinetic fingers will be mounted in different angles, like this. Today I'm just making this prototype, so I'm just having a straight angle to make things a little bit easier. Okay. Okay. And now comes the really fun part. I'm going to start to add balance weights. This is just a temporary weight. There you see it. Now you see how it returns to its inward position immediately. This is one of these things that I know will become absolutely brilliant. And most of all, this will make sense during the concerts. Okay, just a little bit more weight and I think we're home. Imagine when you have 19 fingers next to each other in a piano pattern that falls down and starts to play and you hear the notes at the same time. It's like the visual entry point to the whole mechanic of the whole machine, and then you're gonna want to know what makes these fingers move. I took what I learned from the second prototype over there and I've added this. This is the third prototype. I think that when I'm done with this, this will be my best CAD design. It's like my graduation project. And the reason for that is because of this simplicity in the final look. But if we lift the lid, we have some complexity inside these fingers. There's a lot of functionality built in to a very small space, and I will be able to make 19 individual fingers to perfectly reach every dropping point. If we look at this finger from the front, you can see that there's an angle there. But if we rotate 90 degrees, you can see there's an angle there as well, which means that this line here is a compound angle, which means that to get this to end up nice here in the joint, we have all sorts of angles going on. I'm using one of my favorite tricks. I'm splitting the part in the middle and I'm CNCing two halves of the part. So these black things are going to be printed on the carbon printer by Dr. Phil in the US, and he can deliver amazing prints as we have seen. And these are the pieces that takes care of all these compound angles. So it goes from a plane like this to a plane like that. Then we have a small little 3mm shaft going through this 3D print here. And then we have bronze bushings. These are super small, it's 4mm long bronze bushings that are press fit into the plywood. Also, this counterweight is held in place by the gluing together of the two plywood sides. So all this is really, really, really tiny in the real world. So by CNCing these features in the middle, we can attach things and there's not a visible joint on the outside. I'm super, super excited about that. Look how clean that is. So let's mount this on the machine to finish off and see how that looks. Okay, so I've just temporarily thrown this first prototype in here, and this is not how it's going to look because now all these 19 are identical. They're gonna be completely unique, all of them. And these are not feature creep. It's been planned from the beginning of the whole machine. And I think it's going to be the head turner of the machine. Look at this. Some crazy person had to escape into a mechanical fantasy world for 3 years to cope with his existential angst. That's what this looks like. I've been working really hard on CAD in the background, so here's a cool assembly, the pivot points for the drums. I've been designing that. All these parts are in the mail on the way to me, so I can very soon weld this together and put the drums onto the Marble Machine X once and for all. Which leads to the fact that I then can bend the drop points, which leads to the fact that I then can finish the design of these visual fingers. So there's a whole chain effect when designing on the Marble Machine X, and it's just one step by the time. So thanks so much for being part of this club for delayed gratification. It's a really good trait to be able to have, I think, and I'm honestly so touched by the fact that you're all following this long series. I'm battling my perfectionism and it feels like I'm slowly winning, so we will get there. Thank you so much for following and see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesdays. I tried to make a cool zoom in, but it's impossible because... Oh! What? What is this? It's a hallway inside? Why is there a picture of a garage in the reflection of... what was that? That was crazy. There's a hidden world in here.